Now.
Hopefully this time it works.
Let's go!
Greetings, travelers.
Let's do this!
Try and stay motivated, right?
Okay, let's see here. We're going to start out with a scripture.
I think we're going to try and make it nice and short today.
Let's see here.
Oh yeah, by the way, if you do not want to listen to this, I'd probably skip the next 10 minutes. I'm going to try and make it a little quicker today. Let's see. Where are we going to start at, huh? I guess we could start out with this one's actually a good one. Wrath is cruel, anger is overwhelming, but who can stand before jealousy? See, now jealousy is a very, very interesting one. Because there was this book, and the thing is sometimes I say these things over and over again because it's also good for my own mind to remember them, and sometimes, like, for me, I don't know, I feel like sometimes for me I have to, like, keep reminding myself of these things, otherwise I end up forgetting. But this one, there, I do try and remember because there was this book that I read in, when I used to live in Long Beach at Barnes & Noble. And basically it was going into saying, like, coveting, like, it was about coveting. And basically, as I remember it, is that comparisons can open the gateway into coveting. And coveting, left unchecked, can lead into feelings of envy and jealousy. And I think they started going into, like, envy and jealousy. If you go down deeper into the roots of them, they can start springing into, like, you comparing your own life with somebody else's, and then you might start feeling sad and depressed about your life, or you could get angry at your own life and get angry at others. And then they started, like, going down into, like, or, like, going up the root of, like, jealousies and envies, and then we get into, like, sadness and anger. And what they were talking about is, like, anger at times can transform into sadness and depression, and vice versa. Sadness and depression can turn into anger. And then they were basically saying the whole stem of it all. I'm probably butchering a lot of it, but they were basically saying that coveting is the last commandment because it leads to so many other sins, right? And that coveting's just such a big one, like. And I think they were also talking about, like, how coveting, it can happen so subtly in our modern society. And it's just something to be aware of. And now, I need to look up another verse on this, or a commentary. Proverbs 27:4. Commentary. Okay, well, this person says, knowing the danger of jealousy, a wise person will take care not to provoke it. In particular, he will steer clear of stealing friends or wives or husbands from others. If he is successful in work or friendship, he will be alert of the possibilities of envy directed at him. Anger will abate. Let's see what this one is. This is a different, this is a Bible study tool, right? Let's go into this one. Let's read the Benson commentary. Okay. Proverbs 27:4. Wrath is cruel and doth many barbarous things, and anger is outrageous, often depriving a man of the proper use of his reason, and hurrying him into many mischiefs and miseries. But who is able to stand before envy? Envy is worse than both of them. See, envy is such a gnarly one, dude. Envy is like, the thing about it is that I feel like envy, we can be envious and not even realize that we're envious or jealous, right? And it's like this like subtle, like hidden wound, right? Okay, so back to the commentary. First, because it is more unjust and unreasonable as not being caused by any provocation, as wrath and anger are, but proceeding from mere malignity of mind, whereby a man is grieved for another man's happiness, in which he ought to rejoice. Second, because it is more deeply rooted and implacable, whereas the other passions are commonly allayed. And third, because it is more secret and undiscernible, and therefore the mischievous effects of it are hardly avoidable, whereas wrath and anger discover themselves, and so forewarn and forearm a man against danger. Okay, this is Matthew Poole's commentary. Envy is worse than both of them, partially because it is more unjust and unreasonable, as not caused by any provocation, as wrath and anger are, but only proceeding from a malignity of mind, whereby a man is grieved for another man's happiness, in which he should rejoice, partially because it is more deeply rooted and implacable, whereas the other passions are commonly allayed, and partially because it is more secret and undiscernible, and therefore the mischievous effects of it are hardly avoidable. Whereas wrath and anger discover themselves, and so forewarn and forearm a man against danger. See, now how do you heal envy and jealousy in a biblical sense, right? Do you heal envy and jealousy? I mean, I guess it would be learning to be content, right, with what God has placed you in the position that where God, you know, has you in, right? This is what this one says. The root cause of jealousy and envy are connected to a person's inability to see what God has provided in their life and a lack of thankfulness. James 3:16 states, "For where envy and self-seeking exist, confusion and every evil thing are there." I think that's also another thing, just learning how to be thankful, right? Thankfulness Bible verses. Okay, 1 Thessalonians 5:18. Give thanks in all circumstances, for this is the will of God in Christ Jesus for you. Psalms 104. Enter his gates with thanksgiving and his courts with praise. Give thanks to him. Bless his name. Oh yeah, so Philippians 4:6, do not be anxious about anything, but in everything by prayer and supplication with thanksgiving, let your requests be made known to God. I think in some cases, I think sometimes maybe even being anxious, right? Almost like trying to put thought in the morrow, right? Is like, it can almost like speed up your anxieties, right? And sometimes maybe you can look at others and maybe it can spurn forth envy and jealousy. But yeah, envy and jealousy is such a big one. And I think that's definitely something that, you know, even, you know, it's like, it's not like I'm immune from all this stuff as well, right? I think just in our modern society, as it is at the moment, I think it's just so easy to be envious or jealous of other people, right? Just because that's kind of like, and in some cases, I think companies actually promote that, right? We almost covet things that we, you know. I guess the weird thing would be is how do we heal like, how would you heal jealousy and envy in others, right? Like, that's the other thing. But yeah, wrath is cruel, anger is overwhelming, but who can stand before jealousy? Coveting. Coveting's a big one. Anyway, I guess we'll just get back into it. We'll do another, let's do a carb rating. Thing is, I'm probably going to end up doing, like, studies on things multiple times as well, you know, just over and over. No, because it's good, I think, in some degree, right? Because it can help better put it into your mind. But yeah, it's so easy. I mean, I think that's another thing, is to be aware, like, to be aware when you are jealous or envious, right? It can be very subtle. It can be so subtle, I've heard, that you don't even realize it. So that's a very, very, it can be very deceptive, I think, in some degrees. And yeah, I think it's good to pay attention to that. Let's see what we draw. Now we'll get back into, I'm actually just gonna do another, the triple fire hydrant. Okay, first card. Jorgara Tree Speaker. Second card. Aegis Angel. I like this card. This card's cool. Third card. Glimpse the Future. Fourth. Island. Fifth. Elvish Visionary. From this tiny sprout, the greatest trees grow and flourish. May the seeds of your mind be equally fruitful. See, that's the other thing. So even just drawing this one card, it's weird. I know it sounds completely bizarre, but this is actually one of the reasons why I have some of these cards in here, right? Because here's another thing. Because also, there's that passage. I need to remember it. But the passage of, doesn't Jesus want us to bear a lot of fruit? Bear more fruit. Every branch in me that beareth not fruit, he taketh away. And every branch that beareth fruit, he purgeth, that it may bring forth more fruit. You know, in some cases, I feel like, it's almost like I feel we can be trapped by envy and jealousy, right? Because sometimes when we're so envious and jealous of other people, it can almost like hinder our ability to keep pushing forward, right? Sometimes I think that would even hinder people from even trying, right? So, and Jesus wants us to be fruitful, right? I mean, that's the thing, man. That, let's learn more about Jesus wanting us to be fruitful. Let's see here. Huh. So as to walk in the manner worthy of the Lord, fully pleasing to him, bearing fruit in every good work, and increasing in the knowledge of God. So this is Galatians 5:22-23. But the fruit of the Spirit is love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, self-control. Against such things there is no law. I think the one that I have... Okay, so the one that I have trouble with is patience, definitely. Because, you know, I've actually heard that patience and anger are somewhat kind of... Those can kind of correlate, right? Because sometimes when you lose your patience, right, you can just get frustrated. You're like, argh! You know? That's kind of what happens on my bike sometimes. You know, I just get so, like, impatient to land something, right? And it's just, like, sometimes it's just so frustrating, you know? Like, when you're doing something over and over and over and over again. But then also, it's, like, I guess it's teaching you patience in that very thing, right? I don't know, man. Okay, let's read Jeremiah 17:7-8. Blessed is the man who trusts in the Lord, whose trust is the Lord. He is like a tree planted by water that sends out its roots by the stream and does not fear when heat comes, for its leaf remains green and it's not anxious in the year of drought, for it does not cease to bear fruit. So we're like, are we always supposed to bear fruit, right? I don't know, man. It's like, Fruit. We need to be fruitful. We could do it. So many other things, you know, on this verse, right? Okay. Well, let's continue forth. Not give up, right? Sometimes I feel like these things aren't working. I just get, like, kind of demotivated, but I'm just trying to, like, stay with it, man. I'm literally trying to stay tethered to the word. It's hard sometimes, man, especially when you, I don't know. Does anybody else feel that way? Sometimes I feel like I'm just going upstream and I'm just like, you know, just like, and it's not working or something like that. But I don't know. But we just got to keep trusting the Lord, right? Ooh, Seraph Skyblade. I like this card. Look at that card. Whoa, that card's gnarly. It inspires me to keep going right there, just, you know. 2, 3, 4, 7. Seraph's Litigary. Angelic Destiny. That was the hand today.
See, the other thing is I go through my own doubts. I go through a lot of doubts.
That's weird. It's like, I don't know. I'm just like, sometimes it's like hard doing these things. Like, especially just trying to like, sometimes it's like really hard on the mind sometimes, like trying to glorify God, right? Like how, like, you know, like in Matthew 5:16, which I always bring up, right? You know? All right, let's read it again. In the same way, let your lights shine before others so that they may see your good works and give glory to your Father who is in heaven. You know, sometimes, like, it's weird for me to do this because it's like, sometimes I feel like, man, am I bringing glory to God? Because it feels like it's like, sometimes it feels like it's not really working or something. So it's like, it's kind of like demotivating. And I'm like, man, maybe I shouldn't do it, right? And then, like, but I don't know. And then, I don't know. So that's why I get some weird doubts sometimes. But, I don't know, we're going to go for it, right? At least we could try. I mean, that's the other thing. At least we could try, right? At least we can at least try a little bit. Anyway, let's ride. Let's ride.
triple fire. I need to get this trick down anyway, so. Let's do this! See, Flatland tests your patience, man. If there's anything that tests your patience, like... I literally think this trick cannot be consistent. It's just, there's too many variables. Where's Ronnie? Just gotta keep failing, I guess, right?
Keep failing.
Like I missed like this little like millimeter of the timing or just weight placement and it just doesn't work. Give me like a Charlie horse. Oh, get hit right in the back of the leg. Mm.
Timing. Weight placement. Okay, so we got timing, weight placement. Where we put our foot on the peg. What angle we put our foot on the peg. What angle we put on our foot on the tire. How far we lean forward. How far we lean back. How fast we whip. When we let go of the brakes, when we put the brakes on. At least we landed the one, right? Okay. I don't want to land another one. Let's land another one. I just want to get it unlocked, right? Like, can you get this trick unlocked, or is it just like... I think it's possible, right? Because I've seen some... That's the problem, is that like, that's the weird thing, is when I see people do this trick in particular, you only ever see them landing it. Like I've never, in the flatland riders that I used to ride with, they never really used to do this trick. So like, I don't know, it's like when I don't know, like, is it just always like this where it's just very inconsistent? I don't really know. Or is it like, are there some people that have this trick and they can just do it like, just do it every single time, you know? And I don't really know too many people really to even ask this question, right? We're gonna see if we can land another one. Actually, nah, let's just move on. Right? Yeah, let's do one. Let's do some boomerangs. Boomerang to back in. I haven't done a boomerang track stand in a while, I think. Try and do the switch with 60 out of it. Do another one. Kind of doing alright. I'm almost at the point where I think I can do a double boomerang. I'm ready for those ones yet. Oh.
do want to do a boomerang into Traxton into switch with Stigby. Eventually. Let's actually do a decade to Traxton. I haven't done a decade to Traxton in a while. Brakes are just like, look at these things, they don't even work. I don't know what's wrong with them. I don't need these things. They don't work. It's barely working. Decade track stand. Starting to get a little better at those. Still hard though. It's like hard for me. Bar spin to mega spin? Yeah, I can't do it. I only get it like once out of every 30 tries. Let's do some back here, my handers. Come learn backyard new handers with me. Watch me fail thousands of times. Oh man. Sometimes I feel really like awkward about these streams because it's just like, you know, you're basically, everybody's just seeing my mess ups and sometimes I go, man. Oh man. And then it's like, I don't know. Oh well. Hopefully I'm motivating people right at some degree, but okay, let's do this. Backyard no hander. I think this is actually a switch foot backyard no hander. Starting to progress, I think. Thank you.
just, you gotta fail at something so many times before you start getting it, right? First couple ones are pretty good. Delete. Delete, 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 delete. Let's actually push this up. Actually, I did kind of a good one yesterday, but it wasn't very like leaned up and couldn't get it correctly. Okay, let's try and land one today, right? Because I landed one yesterday and then it was really sketchy though. This is so weird. Okay, I'm being too slow. I gotta really like quicken it up and really get into that opening where you can get into it. It's like trying to get it into where you can land it, put your hands back on the bars. It's feeling very, very awkward right now. would have been it if I would have just pushed it on that one side. Trick feels really inconsistent too. I think there's just too many things going on in that writing. You know what? I'm like messing up the scuff too. Water. Water. You know what? I kind of wanted to learn those too. I wanted to learn Vader to Hang 5. Wow, that's just Vader jam. Push it forward into a hang fire. I've been seeing some riders do that. They do a Vader and then
You can do like a hang five. Hang five, and then like when you're about to lose speed, they like do a Vader and then they push it forward. Vader, push it forward, hang five. You know? I don't really do it. How do you guys do that? Hang five foot jam. What about hang five foot jam? Like just regular foot jam, right? Just break foot jam. Vader, set that up. How to Vader hang five. Well, let's look just see if we can find a clip. How to Vader jam to hang five. BMX. Oh, where is it? Darn, there's no. Man, there's so many tricks though without any how-tos, man. They do it with the other foot. Oh, I've been doing it wrong. I thought I saw somebody do it that way. I guess not. Huh. Oh, shnikes. I'm going to have to learn it the other way then. They do it with this leg. I don't even know how to get it.
basically what you gotta get good at. Oh, that's so weird. Seems like they do it so controlled. I can kind of see how they're doing it now. I think you have to like pivot it, right? I think a lot of them like they go in a circle and they pivot it or something. Dude, I'm almost at that level where I'm gonna do that combo. I mean, not really, but. Okay, what is that? That's hang five, fire hydrant, fakie hang five, forward hang five, fire hydrant, Vader forward. Dude, that is a gnarly combo, dude. Jesus, dude, that is gnarly. Can you imagine doing that? Oh my goodness. A whole nother year in here. I'm just kidding. Actually, maybe not. I don't know. Whole nother year in here to learn that. See, you're having fun, right, Grinder? Windex every time I pass by them. No, should I be doing it that way or should I be doing it up there? Okay, I need to learn fire hydrant to hang five.
Fire hydrant to hang, back to tank fire. Why are fire hydrants so hard? They make them look so easy. They make them look so easy and then I try and do it, it's impossible. Like, I don't see how he's doing it and then he's continuing to go in a straight line. Every time I do it, I pivot out for some reason. Like, he's doing a hang five fire hydrant to backwards hang five. There's actually something. Wait, no, that's what I'm doing. Huh. Dude, I think I've been doing the fire hydrant wrong. That guy didn't do a scuff in the first one. Maybe that's what's making it hard. happened if I plug my PSI up?
Gonna make it more hard.
Need a fire hydrant. That was gnarly. Fire hydrant to... There's so many fire hydrant combos. This guy was doing fire hydrant. Fire hydrant to this to steamroller. Or I mean, you can do fire hydrant steamroller to hitchhiker, fakie hitchhiker. Dude, the fire hydrant, there's a lot of combos you could do into it. It's crazy. He just jumped right into the hitchhiker. Dude, maybe that's how I should learn it. How the heck did he do that? You okay?
Yeah.
Okay, you can do manual. Wow, very interesting.
Back. Why am I tired today? I don't know if I'm just like exhausted today or if I'm just tired. I don't know. I'm really like out of it. Put on some music. Ugh. Do some switch foot, sticky brushes. Let's just do the combo I wanted. I've been after this combo. I've been wanting to do this combo. so hard to get into. I just got into one, I can't get into it again, yeah. No worries. Just gotta learn to be patient, right? See, my energy's sapped. Oh! I'm gonna try to keep going though. interesting. He's using a mirror. Tired. Oh, they're gonna end stream soon this day.
The heck is this?
You're lucky today. Our team gives you a promo code for 10 viewers for a whole day. Today is rest day. Or not a rest day. Well, I guess it is. I'm just beat, man. For some reason, I'm just tired. I need to eat more or something. I'm gonna end the stream.
Farewell, everybody! Probably tomorrow's more energetic, right? What happened to my energy? I think I just need to eat more, man. Farewell.